kinds of spirits in terms of people, or holy and unholy spirits. And so once we're holy spirits, because we've been regenerated and we belong to God, and now we're being trained from babes to mature warriors in Him, champions, to then we go out to champion others. We don't do with that power what the world does. The world competes and covets, but we champion others. That's what we do with our power. It's the power of love. It's not the love of power that's in operation in God's kingdom. So the higher you go in His hierarchy of authority, the more sacrificial the person's going to be, right up to and including the person whose name is a name of above all names, which is Jesus Christ. He is the greatest sacrificial in the universe. And so in God's kingdom, the higher the title, the more the power, the more sacrificial the spirit is, whether it be a person, a holy person, a saint, an angel, or a king. There's kings of kings there. And the King of Kings Himself is Jesus Christ, the second person of the Godhead. And so we get to know the promises of God, the Word of God. We meditate in the Word. We believe what He says. We don't believe how we feel. If what we feel is contradicting what He says, then it's a matter of getting our feelings eventually will line up with the facts. But it's faith first, fact in the Word of God, and then the feelings will come in line after that. The thing about the world is they live by how they're feeling, and that many times is very destructive in and of itself, because our feelings are changeable. They're not reliable guides. We need direction. We get, because we're imitators, and so we grow our character by imitation, and we become stronger by imitation and training, and we get this from the Word of God. And so, you know, the Word of God, that defeats the ignorance, because this Bible says that many of my people perish for a lack of knowledge. And sin, that's another way it comes in, because the Word of God is truth. Jesus Christ is truth. So you look at the person of Jesus Christ and you see how your life lines up with His. How was he? He grew up as we did, right to the point of becoming a minister or a champion that championed others, called His disciples. And so we're to follow the same pattern. And we overcome sin, we overcome vices, we overcome addictions, we may come with all these things that we've learned from the world and the devil and sin that we inherited, but we overcome progressively daily by getting in the Word of God and by seeing what is sin versus what is the character of God. So you study the person of Jesus Christ in the four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Study the person of Jesus Christ and written by His apostles, who also, by the way, gave their lives for Him. They were martyred for Him because they loved Him. Not a forced thing. Once you belong to the kingdom of God, now you truly do have a choice. You have the power of choice. Whereas when we were in the kingdom of Satan, as sinners born in sin, eventually, you know, He chokes out your choices to the point where, you know, if He could, He would devour us. He's called the devouring lion. And so He's in direct contrast with the person of Jesus Christ. And so Jesus Christ would be like an advocating attorney. The devil would be like the prosecuting attorney who sets you up, tricks you with lies and managing images, etc., working with the desires of your heart to get you go about it in an illegitimate manner. That's called sin. And then getting you addicted or getting you in a destructive relationship called idolatry, or because betrayal destroys. It destroys the heart, for example. And to the degree that we've learned these ways from the world, the Lord is delivering us along the way from sin to holy, like He is, or absolute integrity. And so we overcome these ways more and more as we learn. And He does allow us to make our mistakes to learn, but He chastises those He loves that belong to Him. So there's no getting away with anything. There's going to be pretty severe consequences. If you belong to the Lord, He's going to make sure you're not going to repeat unholy ways. You're not going to continue in sin. He's going to put you on such a learning curve, you know. So we get back on the narrow way to becoming what the Bible says we are, which is more than conquerors in Him who gave Himself for us and loved us. So we get back on the championing road so that we might eventually become ourselves ministers of righteousness, just like He was, in order to champion others. And so we get in the Word of God to find out what our calling is and what our spiritual gifts are. There's 5 callings, and there are spiritual gifts, and I'll be reading about those at the end. I'm going to do my Bible reading at the end because I'm going to try to go through this fairly quickly so that I can see if it's even going to work so I can post it. If it doesn't, well, you know, I tried. The devil, another way he works is through intimidation, like I was saying, which can take many forms. Fear of loss, basically, or compromise because you want something illegitimately. So the thing you want is good, but you have to go about getting it in a way that's less than holy, or, you know, what God calls a sin. And what do we mean by sin? Well, let's start with the 10 commandments. So you can go into Deuteronomy and read about the Ten Commandments. Or look in the back of your Bible. You'll see a concordance. Look up the 10 Commandments and make yourself familiar with that, because Jesus did not come to abolish the law. He said he came here and He fulfilled it. So we are going to be more and more character, integrity, holiness, which is, will be fulfilling those laws as well, just as did our Lord. It's called the fruits of faith. So grace does not make us less inclined, because His Holy Spirit's in us, empowering us, and like I said, He's dealing with us in life, chastising us if we go the wrong way. So He will save us, and we will become people of integrity and character. So, we're saved by grace, though, and we do increasingly overcome our sins and overcome the world and overcome evil and addictions and whatever in the power of Jesus Christ. And finally, death, by the resurrection life, the Holy Spirit that's now in us, because we're now the living temples of God. This is His temple now. It's not in a building. It's in our hearts. And He renews our hearts and our minds. And this is done through His word, prayer. That's communion with God. So we're not in a religion. We're in a relationship. That's the difference between this and any other religion. It's not mind concepts only, or fluffy feelings. It's a relationship. And He is not just Savior, He is also King. So we learn to trust Him.